A low-pressure area off the waters of Davao City will bring rains to the region, while the northeast monsoon will affect Luzon and the Visayas. Let's get more details now from ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Carmina, the low-pressure area east of Mindanao has dissipated and was absorbed into the broader circulation of a new low-pressure area that formed just east of it. At 10 this morning, this new LPA was located 740 kilometers east of Davao City. It is unlikely to develop into a storm and may dissipate tomorrow after it makes contact with Mindanao. Its rougher extension, however, will bring scattered rains over Mimaropa, Visayas, Sulu Archipelago, northern Mindanao, and Caraga. Thunderstorms will also be experienced over the rest of Mindanao in the afternoon. Flooding and landslides are possible in these areas. The surging Amihan, meanwhile, continues to advance southward, and light rains are expected in Batanes and Mabuyan Islands. And later today, up to moderate steady rains will also be experienced in mainland Cagayan Valley and the eastern section of Cordillera. Due to big waves from the strong Amihan, small sea craft are not allowed to travel over the seaboards of Ilocos Region, Cagayan Valley, Aurora, Northern Quezon, Bicol Region, and Calayaan Islands. Metro Manila will be mostly cloudy today, but with sunny breaks and no chance of rain for the remainder. And for the remainder of the week, Amihan will wane by Thursday and surge again beginning Friday, and will reach Palawan and Visayas by the weekend. The shear line will also form and bring rains over southern Luzon and eastern Visayas, and another LPA may also develop and head towards Mindanao by weekend. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas there. President Marcos, meanwhile, says he would have fewer trips abroad this year. Marcos said his administration would instead do follow-ups on the deals made in his previous visits. His only confirmed trips for 2023 are his visit to Japan next month and his attendance at the APEC summit in the U.S. come November.
Dapat naman talaga ang Philippine President kailangan pumunta sa lahat ng APEC. Importante talaga at marami talagang napapag-usapan kahit yung kuminsan 5 minutes lang mag-usap kayo, pero mula doon meron na bigbigay na kayo ng number, pwede mo nang tawagan, pwede mo na i-follow up. I don't know the exact figures of the cost and everything, but for example, we came back from China with pledges of 22 billion. Let's say we get actual out of that 1 billion, bawing-bawi lahat ng 8 trips. Finished. The measure of success will be, you know, the cost benefit.
House lawmaker Arlene Brosas, meanwhile, opposes the president's statement.
Di po yung totoo eh. Kasi ng mga nakaraan, nakita naman natin, may mga agreements na nagpo-pursue talaga, natutuloy, pero may mga agreements at kalakhan ng agreements, it will take years bago mangyari. It's a lame excuse na sabihin na kick off ito kasi yung iba namang mga presidente hindi rin naman ito ginawa. Sinasabi niya, edi maganda, good news for us na mag-aasikaso ka na ng tunay na reality dito sa ating bansa. Pero kailangan po kasi yun in action eh, hindi naman yun sinasabi lang eh. So we will see kung ano talaga yung patutunguhan ng pamamahala ng Pangulo na ito.
Marcos has had 8 foreign trips since assuming office last June. President Marcos says he will restructure the Agriculture Department before he designates a full-time secretary for it. The concurrent agriculture chief says he also wants to help Filipino farmers boost their production before he turns over the agriculture portfolio to another cabinet official.
Once I know that the value chain has already been put together, never mind that it is functioning yet, but we already know what needs to be done in each part of that value chain, and we have the means and we have a plan, then we will have a secretary who will then take my place and will implement that plan. There's some reorganization that needs to be done in the Department of Agriculture for the simple reason that we are doing different things from what we were doing before.